All right, welcome back everyone to another top eight. This time I'm going to do the top eight standard cards from Worldwake. The Pro Tour is coming up, so we'll get to see how spot on my predictions were. At number eight, I've got Core Firewalker. Maybe not going to see a ton of main deck play, but definitely sideboard. Does a pretty good job of beating red decks. So if red gets too good, there's always the Firewalker. Number seven, I've got another guy with a pretty intensive casting cost, Leatherback Baloth. A pretty natural fit in any sort of mono green deck with one drop acceleration. Baloth, he's done a pretty good job so far in our testing of beating down turn two Baloth, especially with like a Noble Hierarch. Puts a lot of pressure on them and makes them kind of demand a terminate. Next up is Abyssal Persecutor. A pretty exciting card. A lot of people thought it was going to be awesome, and it's been pretty good. It's not been insane, but it's been definitely good enough to make the top eight. I mean, you have to have enough ways to kill it, but generally your opponent's not going to want it to put them to negative, so they'll usually do that for you. At number five, we've got a card that a lot of people, myself included, were very excited about, Treasure Hunt. On average, it draws you 1.7 cards in a 26-land deck, but once you add in, you know, Jace's Brainstorm or Halimar Depths, you're talking a pretty serious amount of action for only 2 mana. So far, I've been pretty happy with Treasure Hunt, and my record right now is 9. Granted, it was on turn 2, so I had to discard most of them, but hitting 9 is pretty good. Next up is Treasure Hunt's compatriot, Calcite Snapper. Goes in pretty much all the same decks. He does a pretty good job of stopping pretty much anything they could throw at you. The Convertible Turtle gives Grixis a good answer to Sprouting Thrynax or any sort of tokens, and he can just all of a sudden attack them for 4, which is pretty good. Number 3, we've got Tectonic Edge, which does a good job of combating a lot of the mana bases nowadays, and especially the new cycle of manlands, which you'll notice I haven't mentioned yet. Tectonic Edge also punishes any deck with expensive spells and fits really well in all sorts of monocolor decks. Vampires, mono green, etc. It's basically like, you know, a land spell, and imagine how good Wasteland would be. At number 2, we've got a cycle of lands, the man lands, like Raging Ravine, Creeping Tar Pit. So far, these have fit very well, and the only one I haven't actually played with so far is the black-red one, Lava Claw Reaches. Any deck that is playing two of the colors is going to want a couple of these because it's a very cheap cost. Coming to play tap duel that adds two of the colors, and all of a sudden late game they do a fantastic job of beating down. It's also kind of a 2-for-1 having your lands do stuff. Number 1, as he is on most of the lists that feature him, is of course Jace the Mind Sculptor. All our blue decks have been playing 4 and I haven't regretted it for a second. So if blue deck's good, which I'm not saying it necessarily is because, you know, I'm having a little trouble getting it to work against all these Jun decks, Jace is going to be a 4 of, and I think maybe his price tag is pretty high, but at this point it seems well deserved. So that's my top 8 from Worldwake for standard. And yeah, like I said, we'll see how the Pro Tour shakes things up. Thanks for watching.